Hi friends, my name is Raj Shekhar Reddy, and if you are seeing my video for the first time, just don't forget to subscribe my channel and click the bell icon. This is my GitHub repository and I will place my source code in the GitHub. In this video, we are going to see, we will develop one Spring Boot application and we will deploy in the Docker and we will run in the Docker container. How exactly we are going to see by using an example. For that, what I am trying to do is I am trying to create a normal Spring Boot project. Just create new Spring Starter project. Here I am giving Spring Boot Docker demo I am giving. After that, just click on next. Here I am adding only one dependency, web dependency. I want to write on REST endpoint. I want to expose it. Just click on finish. Just I am trying to open the pom.xml file and let's see what the dependencies we added. You can see that only one dependency is available here. That is nothing but Spring Boot Starter web dependency we added. Now what I am trying to do is, now I am trying to write one REST endpoint here. I am not creating any other another class, just I am writing here at get REST controller, just I am trying to import it. I am writing one method public string hello. I am returning one statement, that is nothing but welcome to Docker I am writing. On the top of the method, I am annotating with get get mapping and I am giving the URL pattern as /hello. Other than that, nothing I am writing. In order to deploy your Spring Boot application in the Docker, we need to create one file, that is nothing but Docker file we need to create. Just what I am trying to do is, just I am trying to create a Docker file here. Just right click new file. The file name is Docker. The file name should be in the same name, like the D should be in uppercase. Click on finish. In the Docker file, we need to write something like from OpenJDK 8. We are using Java 8 and I want to expose in the port number something like 9090, and I want the jar file will be the, I am giving the file name. Let me open my pom.xml file and I will give the project name here. I want my Spring Boot application name should be fixed. So that way, what I am trying to do is, just here I am writing, there is one tag available, final name. When I am giving the file name as Spring Boot -docker-demo. This is my application name, Spring Boot application name. The same name here I am using here. The jar file will be generated in the target folder. The jar name is Spring Boot -docker-demo. And I want to deploy in the root directory of my Docker. And I am trying to run this image by using java-jar. How exactly we are running that jar file, we are giving the same thing here. This is how we need to do. After that, what I am trying to do is, now I am trying to maven install here. Right click maven install. It will take for a while in order to generate jar file. Yes, you can see that the build got succeeded and the jar file it got generated. Just what I am trying to do is, just I will start my what I will do is I am trying to start my Docker Quick install here. I am starting my Docker Quick start terminal here. You can see that my Docker is up and running. Here what I am trying to do is, just I am going to my project work location. I am trying to open here the command prompt here. Just I am testing for, I am testing Docker. Yes, Docker is up and running. What I am trying to do is, now I want to build my Docker image here. For that there is a command available. Docker build hyphen t and give the jar name here. Dot jar, just click on enter. Just we need to give the location also. I want to print the current directory, click on enter. It will take for a while. It want to download the OpenJDK and everything. You can see in my case it is already downloaded, so that's why it's fast. In your case it will be taking for a while. So typically it will take 5 to 10 minutes. You can see that it is successfully generated the image. The image name is Spring Boot -docker-demo.jar. This is the name and it is the latest. What I am trying to do is, now I am on to trying to run the Docker image. What I am trying, Docker run and give the image name. Before running this, I want to run in the port number. I want to run in the port number 9002. And my local port number is 9090 and I want to run the Spring Boot -jar. Just click on enter. You can see that we got the Spring logo. I think it is getting started. I think the Tomcat has started in the port number 8080. What I will do is, let me stop my Docker. What I will do is, just go to your Spring STS. I will change the port number in the application.properties. Here I am giving the server.port equal to some 9010 I am giving. In the Docker file also I am trying to give the same port number 9010. Trying to save. What I am trying to do is, now I am trying to Maven clean and Maven install, so that we will get the latest jar we will get. Just the clean got success. Now I am trying to run Maven install also. Is the build got success? We got the latest jar. What I am trying to do is, now I am trying to run the same commands here one more time. Docker build -d Spring Boot -demo.jar. You can see that the image got successfully generated. Now what I am trying to do is, I am trying to run in the port number. I am taking, and the local port number is 9009010. What I am trying to do is, now I am trying to run my image. You can see that the Spring logo has come in. Yes, the application got started in the port number 9010, but we need to access the port number 9005. What I am trying to do is, now I am trying to open my browser and try to test it. Localhost 9005/hello. I think it is not working. What we need to do is, just go to the kickstart. We need to, instead of localhost, we need to give this IP address in order to access the Docker port number. What I will do is, just replace the localhost with the IP address. Just click on enter. Now you can see that we are able to access welcome to Docker. If you want to run with the localhost, what we need to do, we need to give the port number as 9010/hello. It need to work, but somehow it is not working. In order to access the Docker image, we need to give the IP address colon port number. Whatever the port number you are giving while running the Docker image, you can see that Docker run -p, this port number we need to give in order to access our rest endpoints. That's it for this video. Thank you friends, thank you for watching. I will place my source code in the GitHub and I will provide link in the description. And if you are seeing my video for the first time, just don't forget to subscribe my channel and click the bell icon.